Welcome to the second section on lipids. This section is covering digestion and absorption. I'm just going to start by just orienting you to this diagram. It's a little bit confusing. Food comes from the mouth down the esophagus into the stomach. So this is the stomach outlined right here. From the stomach, it goes into the small intestines. What's not shown here is the blood supply because the bloodstream, because the nutrients go from the intestines into the bloodstream. The structure here is the pancreas, and remember the pancreas releases enzymes into the small intestines for digestion. The liver is shown here and synthesizes the bile, makes the bile, and then the gallbladder shown here is what holds the bile and then releases it into the small intestines when fat comes into the small intestines. So when we start with the intestines, remember this is right here, this is the main organ of both digestion and absorption. So remember, digestion is the breakdown of food into its individual nutrients, while absorption is absorbing those nutrients into the bloodstream. Bile has an important function here, especially with lipids. With lipids, it's going to help both with digestion and absorption. So it allows, as soon as the fat comes in, the lipids come into the small intestines, the gallbladder will release bile into the small intestines. And it acts as an emulsifier. What that means is it's going to allow that fat to basically travel in an aqueous or a liquid environment. Remember, the fat and water don't really combine, and an emulsifier allows them to combine. Now, the small lipids, and what I mean by the small lipids, are the fatty acids and the glycerol. And if you remember, the triglyceride, this is the fat that we eat, a triglyceride, three fatty acids in a glycerol backbone. They're broken apart. That's part of the digestive process. It's digesting, breaking that apart. And those fatty acids and glycerol will go directly to the bloodstream. So in the esophagus, the stomach, into the small intestines, they will travel and then go directly to the bloodstream. They'll get absorbed into the body. Now, the larger lipids can't actually do that. They ended up being repackaged. They're broken down to some extent, but then repackaged back into chylomicrons. They go into the lymphatic system instead of just going into the bloodstream. And they'll eventually make it to the bloodstream, but they're actually absorbed into the lymphatic system first, to the lymph vessels. Now, this is a demonstration, an image, a graphic showing you how bile actually works. And if we look at bile, we can see it has a hydrophilic side and a hydrophobic side. So hydro means water, phobic, you can think of scared of. You have a phobia, you're scared of it, right? So hydrophobic, so this is not water loving. And then we have a hydrophilic, this is more water loving. So if we had to get this lipid to travel in a watery environment, how could we do that? Well, we take something, an emulsifier like bile, and the water-fearing side, or the fat-loving side, we could say, is actually going to attach to the fat. But then it shows its water-loving side all the way around. So that's the way it's very easy for this lipid to travel in an aqueous environment. And to take this a little bit further, I want you to think about, you know, what happens if you were to pour an oil into water? And the salad dressing is a great example. You put it in there, and eventually it might be in a bunch of little droplets. You might actually see those droplets, but what happens when you pull out a salad dressing? You see the water and the fat, right? Well, the bile allows it to surround, the bile surrounds that fat. It surrounds that fat, and that fat is contained. And in the outside, remember, if we go back, the outside is actually water-loving. So this is able to travel very easily in water. So it allows a bunch of little tiny fat droplets to travel in water, and it actually can form a suspension or what they call an emulsion as well. So again, this, as far as digestion and absorption, it aids in both the digestive process because then it makes it easier for enzymes to digest the fat, but also to aid in absorption.